Blackstone Audio presents The Life Before Her Eyes by Laura Kasischke. For Bill. Voici que vient l'été, la saison violente, et ma jeunesse est morte, ainsi que le printemps. Summer is coming, the violent season, and my youth, dead with the spring. Apollinaire. Prologue. April. They're in the girls' room when they hear the first dot 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 of semi-automatic gunfire. It sounds phony and far away, and they keep doing what they're doing, brushing their hair, looking at their reflections in the mirror. Dot dot dot. The mirror is narrow and institutional, but also brilliant. Earlier that morning, the janitor wiped it with Windex and a cloth, and now it's like a peace of mind there, opening, clean as a thought in the mind of a god, a thought cast by the creator of everything onto perfectly calm water. They have to stand shoulder to shoulder to squeeze both of their reflections in. The dark-haired girl, smiling, her arm hooked into the arm of her friend. The blonde, who's been crying but who's laughing now. Still, the crying's made a blurred photograph of her face, her mascara smeared, her image occurring to her as though from the surface of a shimmering pool. I'm just so happy for you, she says to her friend's reflection. Then why are you crying? Her friend asks. She laughs. Because I'm happy. Are you sure you're not jealous? The dark-haired girl asks, passing the hairbrush to her friend. Dot, dot, dot. Dot, dot, dot. What is that? The blonde stuffs her hairbrush, which is now spun with gold and black silk, a miniature angel's nest, back into her backpack next to her anthology of English literature. The pages of that anthology are so thin, they're like dead girls' dreams, translucent skin. On them, it seems that everything that has ever been thought has been written. Knock, 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 knock. This time, it's followed by a soft and gurgling scream. The scream of someone slipping suddenly into a warm bath. Shit, one of the girls says. What the hell? One of the girls starts toward the door, but the other grabs her elbow. Don't go, she says. What if... What? I don't know. She drops her friend's elbow. It's just a prank. It's probably Ryan Asswipe. Dot, dot. So loud this time, close and mechanically bright, that both girls scream. Their screams are followed by a silence that sounds foolish, cold and hard as the tile on the girls' room walls. One says in a whisper, It's Michael Patrick. Yesterday, in Trig, he told me he was going to bring a gun to school, that he was going to kill... Who? Kill who? Everybody. What? All you fuckheads, he said. I thought he was joking. You know what a freak. Why didn't you tell anybody? On the other side of the door to the girls' room, there's another scream. It sounds desperate and pointless as music, and it's followed by a man asking for help. Help, is all he says. Mr. McLeod? Then silence, except that one of the girls is wearing seven silver bangles on her right wrist, and both girls gasp when they jangle. The other grabs the bangles on her friend's wrist and holds them still with her hand. Then he opens the door slowly and steps in. He's holding a big blue-black gun with both hands, pointing it in front of him, aiming at nothing. When he sees them, Michael Patrick laughs. Hey, he says. One of the girls, trying not to sob, swallows, then says, Michael! He's wearing a shiny shirt, a clean and pale white shirt, but there are large, ugly sweat stains under his arms. There's an angry rash under his chin where he must have shaved too fast that morning. Michael Patrick smiles. He's breathing hard. He takes one of his hands off the grip of the gun and puts the hand in the pocket of his jeans. He's wearing white shoes with blue lightning bolts on the sides, laces untied. "So," he says, too loudly in the quiet softness of the girls' room, and both girls flinch. "So," he says more softly, as if sorry to have startled them, "which one of you girls should I kill?" Neither girl breathes. Both of them look at his face as if for the first time. What is he standing in the girls' room with a gun?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.